Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. This is not a somber function. This is a function to celebrate, to pay tribute to somebody who has contributed so much to all our lives. Lives of great people remind us that we can make our life sublime, and departing leave footprints on the sands of time. That is what this great lady has done. There are many things that we can recount about her. Many people will recount many things about her, and I shall leave all those to them. I just want to dwell on a few important facets of her life. She was a person who had true guts, true grit, and true passion, which was evidenced by the fact that as early as you saw in the picture, in the year of 1958, she started a school. And how? By her own gut and by her own passion to impart education. Now let's look at this a little more seriously. Five ladies in an area called Nungambakkam form a group called the Nungambakkam Ladies Recreation Club. It is called the Nungambakkam Ladies Recreation Club. And all the five ladies, if I remember a few names, Savitri Ganesan, Dr. Lakshmi Chaturvedi and Rajamma, they all had social standing. Forming a ladies recreation club, as the name suggests, they could have indulged in some kind of recreation. Instead, she chose to start a school. That itself shows enormous passion. Gut. Where does this gut come from? And you know what she was competing with and what she wanted to start it? She started a Hindu boys school with only five people, of whom I was one, on a rooftop. The rooftop was in the Chandralekha Muthuswami Street, which is near this Valluvar Kotam today, which is fairly unrecognizable as you see it. It was on a rooftop with a thatched hut. Five students. That shows passion. And starting in 1958 with just five students, with the gut and the grit and the passion, in the year 1961, Bala Bhavan, as it was called, moved to the premises where this Bala Bhavan lake area now stands. Again, thatched roof. Bit by bit, brick on brick, she built the school. All by herself, through by sheer grit, the guts to stand up, and by sheer passion. Sometimes I wonder, and once I told her also, same place, sitting next to her, when she used to tell me, "Dey naalik endha program irukku vaada appadinu va na varala appadinu va illa da nanna appa paakkuradhukku va appadinu va." I once told her, "I think you are an education terrorist." "Enna appadi solra appadina?" "Yeah, because when she was in school, she was a terror for the students. She used to be very, very strict, and she used to even whack. Even less, she used to whack freely and merrily. She used to be left-handed, I think. At least she used this for the whacking purpose. Patar patar na adipa." So she was a terror because she was running a boys' school. Please understand that. She was running a boys' school. She was a terror. And that's how the discipline was created in the school. She was a terror for the boys. She was a terror for all the chief guests who came to her function. Everyone get her, unabashedly she asked for donation. The school was so small, it was only a thatched roof, and she had to build it. She never fought shy of telling people, "I hope before he leaves, he will donate some money to our school." And whatever they had to give, you saw all the buildings. Terrorist to all the chief guests. Most importantly, she was a terrorist for all the schools who were then existing. The reason is, we went to the school finals with only 7 students. We went to school finals in second year in 1969 with 9 students, and we got the university first in the second batch of only 9 students. So she was a terror to all the other big schools, all the missionary schools, all the other schools were functioning. Holy Angels, Church Park, Good Shepherd, Don Bosco, where her own children were studying. She didn't put her children in her school anyway. So that was the kind of terrorist that she was, and when I told her you were an education terrorist, she said, I like this title very much, Avina. Look at her contribution to the family. As Mahendra mentioned, as you have seen in the audio visual, she was a great pillar of support to a gentleman called YGP to pursue his own passion. I was told that when, after having started UAA, the United Amateur Artists, having done a lot of plays of success, having groomed many stars of great caliber, as you all saw, as Pattu moved on, I was told, and I want Mahendra to kind of validate it a little later, that he got into some kind of a depression. He wanted to close down his dramatic activities and his troupe and all that. But she said, no, hang on, do a play. And she got ARS and others into the act. And they did some other play, if I'm not wrong, some undersecretary or some play like that, which I don't recall very clearly. And they restarted. She stood as a pillar of support to her husband to follow his own passion. And after that, you know, they groomed many, many more stars to come by. So as a homemaker, as a person, as a wife, as a mother, as you have seen, I don't know how to elaborate on that, what a fine mother she has been, allowing her children to grow. She was amazing. Not that she was so focused in her own career that she completely forgot or got kind of away from what she had to do otherwise as her responsibility towards her home. So that's a great, great, great thing, because many times when you're focusing on your career solely, you will find people at the end of their career saying, I think I have not given enough time to my family. This is what people normally say. But in her case, she was able to balance both and give enough time to both her profession and to her family. She was a great patron of arts, as you all know. She loved music, she loved dance, she loved drama, she loved theater, she loved everything that she saw. Everything was so exciting to her. And she has groomed so many, having started Bharat Kalachar, having given away so many awards today, so many people who are now ruling the roost as captains of many fields in fine arts. They've all been groomed by her. You saw all the names there on the screen. What a fine patron of art she was. Most importantly, one fine characteristic which I found in her is her ability to appreciate people very easily. If they deserve. She would never fight shy of appreciating any good work that she saw. Whenever she sees something, either in press, or she sees a photograph, or she sees your interview, or she sees you doing something, she'll be the first person to call. Not earlier, even as late as a couple of weeks back, when her voice was so feeble, when I could hardly understand what she was saying, she would call and say, "Adana paathan, idana kettan, rumba nalla irundhathu, so superb, fantastic." And she was so honest and genuine about it. Appreciation should not be just kind of casual. It has to be genuine, and she was very genuine about it. And she cared and loved for all the people whom she thought deserved appreciation. I'll just give you one small anecdote for you to understand what it means for her to appreciate people. She had come to a special show of a film for which my son Anirudh had scored the music. She was quite unwell. It was not very long ago. And the movie was going on, and it was interval time. We had just broken for interval, and she was wheezing. And I told Rajamani, why don't you just go home and take rest or something? And she said, Nada Solra, the music is fantastic. I love this. And you know what she did? You'll be surprised. She went to the ante room in the theater, in the preview theater, nebulizer. She used a nebulizer, got nebulized, and got back and saw the full show. This is something unimaginable. I wanted to share this with you because it's fairly personal, but then it shows the kind of appreciation that she wanted to bestow on my son, whom she seems she dearly loved. She was 94, but she defied her age. She never allowed age to catch up with her. She was always game for anything at her, whatever be the age, 6 a.m. to 10 p.m. as you saw. She would be at a morning discourse somewhere, she would be at a symposium somewhere, she would be at a special show, she would watch a dance program, she would watch a music recital, and then she would also attend a party. So this was her zest for life. Age, they say, is only a question of mind over matter. She didn't mind it, so it didn't matter. So she captured it. Coming to the Padma Award, there is a feeling that she got it a trifle late. But she never, it never concerned her too much. And she was never bitter about it. In fact, I personally think, to all deserving people, this award, if it comes when it is early, the award embellishes them. If it comes late, they embellish the award. In my view, she embellished the award, for she knew the respect, the devotion, the affection, and the enormous love that she had earned from people all over weighed much more than any award that anybody could give her in life. Ladies and gentlemen, there comes a time when a person of whom whatever is said seems to be inadequate. However much is spoken seems to be inadequate. However we cover the facets seems to be inadequate. However the greatness is covered seems to be inadequate. I looked around to see if I could find somebody like that, and I'm sure you have found the answer. It is Mrs. YGP. None else. Nobody can match a great soul like her. Thank you.
Thank you, Ravi. That came straight from the heart. It's a very nice term. It's the educational terrorist in Sonata. Yes, she was a terrorist. Now, Don Bosco, she asked me to come away from school at 3 o'clock itself. That was the last period. I cut pretty to answer as a parent. There's a Davis Cup match going on between Rafael Osuna and Tennis Krishnan is playing. Your school will never give you permission. It was a mistake. Next day, I got suspended for it. Much later, when she was running a school, I asked her, இன்னைக்கு ஒரு பையன் ஏதாவது தப்பு பண்ணால் பிச்சு உதறிய அண்ட் என்னையே கட் பண்ண சொன்னிய கிளாஸ் இது ஹிப்போக்ரசி தானே ஹிப்போக்ரசி இல்லைடா ஐ லேர்ன் தட் ஆஸ் அ பேரண்ட் ஐ ஷுட் நாட் ஹவ் பீன் செல்ஃபிஷ் ஸோ ஐ எம் நவ் நாட் அலவிங் அதர் பேரண்ட்ஸ் டு பி செல்ஃபிஷ் ஹவ் யூ வெரி கிளவர் ஸோ தட் இஸ் அ லெசன் ஐ லேர்ன் என் பசங்க ஏதோ பார்க்கணுங்கிறதுக்காக மொத்த டிசிப்ளினை கெடுத்தது தப்பு எனக்கு புரிஞ்சு போச்சு ஸோ ஐ எம் எக்ஸ்ட்ரா டிசிப்ளின் ஆகும் ஹவு கேன் யூ ஆன்சர் சச் உமன் யூ கேன் நாட் ஆன்சர் ஹியர் இஸ் அனதர் லேடி ஆல்மோஸ்ட் க்ரோ அப் வித் ஹர் அண்ட் ஹூஸ் பீன் அடோரிங் ஹர் ஃபார் சோ லாங் வி கேனாட் ஃபர்கெட் த லவ்லி டைம்ஸ் வி ஸ்பெண்ட் இன் ஊட்டி இன் செட்டிநாட் பேலஸ் ஐ கால் அப் ஆன் குமார் ராணி மீனாமுத்தி அவர்கள்